What kind of music would a pizza make?
What kind of music would a pizza make?
Blink, toot, honk, oot, clink, clank,
bing, bang, bong.
Absolutely nothing beats a Charlie Horse Music Pizza
Dad? I don't know. Sounds like World War III.
Figaro!
Hey, Cookie! Cookie!
Yes?
What is all this racket?
It's opera. It's opera. It's the most glorious racket in the whole wide world.
Opera.
Yes, do you like plays?
Yes.
Do you like exciting stories?
Oh, yeah!
Yeah, you'd like to hear somebody gloriously singing?
Yeah, it's all right.
Would you like to hear 60 instruments all playing together at the same time?
Wow!
Oh, yeah,
that's what opera is. Isn't it wonderful?
Oh, yeah, it really is. A lot of noise. That's what it is. Yeah, foreign noise. Do you understand a word they're saying? Mm-hmm.
That is because it's in Italian. But you know what you have to do? You have to know what the story is all about. This is the Barber of Seville, and there is this guy, Figaro. And he is pulling all kinds of stunts so that his friend can get together with a lady that he loves. And, by the way, don't worry about the words, because the music will give you a feeling that you'll never forget.
Mm. Hey, what's going on here? Cookie, I got customers in there.
Oh, shh. Cookie. We can't even hear ourselves out there, man. You gotta turn that down.
Sherry, I'm really fed up with this whole darn thing. I'm an opera fan and I'm proud. Ha!
Cookie, I love all the music I hear you sing. But your singing is always too loud. Ha!
I love an opera.
I also love opera.
We love an opera.
You sing it too loud.
Opera is wonderful.
Think of my customers.
And when I sing,
I must protect.
The music is beautiful.
When you sing opera,
fit for a king.
People object.
Why are you taunting me?
You're out of control now.
With this complaint.
No ifs, ands, or buts.
What do you want of me?
It's taking its toll now.
Soon I will feed you a drumming and let you a never stand. I can say with the strength that a critic you ain't. And you're letting your figure go, figure go, figure go, figure go.
My figure is fine. Thank you very much for the flattery.
Oh, yeah? Well, what you know about opera, I can fit into an eensy-teensy flashlight battery.
Opera's drama, a musical drama, a play with a story that's funny or gory. The actors are singers, the singers are actors. They sing you the story right through to the end.
The music is beautiful, so is the scenery.
Everyone's dressed in the finest of scenery.
Hundreds of people are in with the scenery, singing the story right through to the end. I love an opera, I love an opera.
Try singing an opera, but don't sing it so loud. Don't
sing it loud, I'll sing it loud, I'll sing.
Tomorrow is Cookie's birthday.
Ah, and you want to throw him a surprise party, right?
Bingo.
Cool.
That's the good news. The bad news is tomorrow is Cookie's day off. So the question is, how do we get Cookie to come into the restaurant on his day off?
Sherry.
What?
It'll be a piece of cake. We just tell him there's a big party at the Music Pizza, and he'd be a fool to miss it.
Yeah, but this kind of steps on the surprise angle, doesn't it?
Well, we don't have to say it's for him.
Don't stop thinking. Okay, guys, I need your help. How are we going to get Cookie to come into the Music Pizza on his day off? Huh?
What's
do you have
wrong
any
with this picture?
What?
Well, it's not every day you see a lovely lady standing alone on a beach, chattering away to nobody at all.
No, it's not nobody. Those are my, we always,
They?
Forget it. I'm Shari. How do you do?
Oh, Joseph, delighted.
How do you do?
Yeah, it's not every day you see that kind of scene either.
What?
And look at all those kids at the restaurant. Wow. 35 kids. 35 times an average check of $7 equals a lot of money.
Yeah.
Somebody's got themselves a gold mine.
Yeah, that would be me.
Those are your kids?
No, that's my gold mine. A restaurant.
Really?
Oh, sure.
You mean, if I'd had your business savvy, maybe I'd still own the place.
You used to own the music pizza?
Yeah, until 5 years ago. It was Joseph's House of Pies. The pie thing, always the pie thing. The stupid, stupid, stupid. If only I'd found something else beside pies. So, what do you sell in your restaurant?
Pies.
What?
Pizza.
Oh, pizza pies.
Pizza pies.
Yeah.
Why don't you drop in any time and see what we've done with your old place?
Well, tonight okay?
Oh, tonight would be lovely.
Swell. Be there tonight.
So the question is, what are we going to get Cookie for a birthday gift?
No money.
No money?
You kidding? I'm so broke. I can't even afford to pay attention. You know, Cookie would like it much better if we made his gift.
I think she's right.
Yeah, and you know, I have boxes and boxes and boxes of cake mixes. And we could follow the instructions.
Instructions.
And we could make him a birthday cake.
We will. But for his big gift, what does Cookie like the best?
Opera. So let's go to the music store, and we'll buy a box of opera mix, and we'll follow the instructions.
No, darling, operas don't come in boxes. If we wanted to make up an opera for Cookie's birthday, which is not a bad idea, you know.
How do we do it?
Well, first we pick a story, and then we act it out, not in words, but in song.
Right. Yeah.
Because in opera, the actors sing everything.
Everything.
Real opera singers can sing very high, very low, very fast, very slow, and loud enough to be heard in every row of the most enormous theaters.
Oh, yeah, but the opera singers use a microphone.
No, they learn how to do it without hurting their vocal cords.
We need vocal cords to sing, huh? You didn't tell us that we had to buy special equipment.
No, darling. Your vocal cords are two little muscles. They look like this. They're right in your throat. And they bang together. They vibrate. And they create all the sounds that you make.
What makes them bang together?
The air that you breathe as it leaves your lungs.
Oh, yeah. You know, whenever I sing, I run out of breath.
Oh, well, that's because you have to learn how to control the air and let it out slowly.
There.
Thank you, Charlie Horse. You know, opera singers learn to let out a little breath at a time so they can sing long notes. For example, I can let the air out of this balloon all at once. Or I can let it out a little at a time so the balloon sings a long note.
Your voice is a kind of instrument, like an oboe or clarinet. And we're going to play that instrument, so steady, get ready, get set. Relax. That's right. Nothing tense, nothing taut, nothing tight. Head up, stand straight, chin in, chest out, we're about to begin. Fill your lungs and then gently deflate. Place your fingers like so. Sing ah, then sing oh. Do it. Ah, wow. Can you feel your vocal cords vibrate?
They buzz.
They does. That's great. You don't have to scream, you don't have to shout. All you do is breathe.
Tra la la.
Take a deep breath in, let it slowly out. As you sing
tra la la la.
Everything relaxed, natural and free. Let each single note float out from your throat, easy as can be. Feel the sound begin. let it rise and grow free.
La-la-la-la-la, la-la.
You're the violin, and you are the bow. Free.
Tra-la-la-la-la, la-la.
How your voice will soar, more and more and more, way above the orchestra.
Sweet and sure and strong,
singing out your song. Breathe.
Tra-la-la-la-la, la-la.
Do you see them?
Look there.
Hey, you guys, y'all got nuts? Come inside. Hey, Joel, Gordy, you better get home.
What?
You guys, they just announced it. The hugest storm I've ever heard of.
What?
80 mile an hour winds, whip, and rains the whole nine, Sharon. I'm telling you.
What a lovely day.
Wow.
Yeah, here. There.
Oh, we got to shut down before the storm
hits. Yeah, you're right.
Junior, we're going to need sandbags, dear.
Yeah.
Okay, hush, puppy. Go get the mop and the bucket and the broom.
All right.
Charlie Horse, we're going to be ready for this thing.
Yes, sir.
Ooh. Whoa.
Oh, that's going to be some storm, huh?
Going to be a humdinger.
Yeah, I do imagine some dingers are going to get hummed. You seem very relaxed about this storm.
Well, tomorrow is a very special day for me.
Oh, 60 Minutes is on. Yeah, I know how you feel about Morley Safer.
No, no, it's something bigger, much, much bigger than that.
Really?
Well, good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night, Cookie.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Good night.
Oh, Cookie.
Yes.
Is there any chance that you could babysit with the kids tomorrow night?
Tomorrow?
Yeah, I've got this class I've got to go to.
What time do you need me?
7 o'clock.
Done. Simple.
Good, thank you.
Well, arrivederci.
A river. The river's outside, be careful.
Got him. Okay, Mr. Moppy, where are you? Where would you be if you was a mop? Hello, Moppy Moppy, are you in the closet? No, not on that side of the closet. Are you on this side of the closet?
In the corner behind the pail.
No, the mop ain't here. The bum flew the coop.
Well, can you blame him? It's no picnic being crammed in here, let me tell you.
Look at the butterfingers.
Officials are urging everyone within a mile of the ocean to stay indoors until at least noon tomorrow. This is Stormwatch saying, be smart and stay safe.
You know, guys, I think we're going to be camping out here tonight.
All
right. That's cool, buddy.
Yeah, good, good, good. What do you mean, good, good, good? What's the matter with you? Oh, you realize we are right near the ocean? And don't you think we should be sleeping someplace safer, like, say, on the freeway? Oh, what a wuss. Hey, hush, puppy. I am the king of the talking cleaning supplies.
No.
You are mine. Stop it, Charlie Horse. No, wherever you go, my armies of utensils will track you down and talk your ear off.
Charlie Horse, please stop. Hey, kids, come on. It's just a little bit of lightning and thunder. Charlie Horse, will you join us?
You did say tonight, didn't you?
Oh, yes, of course. Come on in. I'm so happy to see you. I want you to meet everybody. Everybody up. Everybody, this is Joseph. He used to own this restaurant.
Hi, everybody.
And this is Junior.
We've met.
Junior. May I have your coat? Junior, would you please hang this? Please? Well, take a seat.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Yeah. Junior and I, we go way back together. Don't we, pal?
Junior?
So, when I came in here tonight, I couldn't...
Sorry.
When I came in, I could...
Kids, please.
When I came in, I couldn't help noticing that everybody was kind of jumpy.
Oh, no, not me. I mean, you know, the storm had them kind of spooked. But not me. Forget about this storm. Let's talk about this stuff in the closet.
What's that?
Well, when you owned this place, you know, 100 years ago or so, did anything strange ever talk to you, like soap or detergent?
Always.
What?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, this place is haunted.
Sherry! Look!
What a lie! Sherry, I never heard anything about any of that.
Sure you did. I must have told him about it 100 times, but did he ever listen? Oh, kids.
Sherry! Wait. Would you please tell me what you mean when you say haunted?
Well, the usual thing.
What?
Plates floating in air, pianos playing by themselves.
Oh.
But there's no need to worry. Nobody has ever been hurt. Yet. Well, maybe I should drop by tomorrow after the storm's blown over.
Yeah, I think that would be a good... Oh, no. We have to pick another time. Tomorrow we're giving a surprise party for our cook. Cookie?
Well, yeah? If the party's for the cook, I'll bet you the cookie isn't doing any cooking.
I forgot all about the food.
So I'll tell you what. Why don't I whip up some chow for the party tomorrow and then drop by you?
Oh, I couldn't ask you...
What time?
8 o'clock.
8 o'clock.
Thank you.
Good night.
Bye-bye.
Junior.
Junior, that was unbelievably rude.
No. Yes. That was unbelievably polite.
I can't imagine you're treating another human being like that.
I guarantee he's lying about this place being haunted.
Well, now, wait a second. I remember enough with the talking drones.
Hey, Charlie. Come on. Hush. Listen to me. I promise you that this is a ghost-free zone.
Yeah, well, I promise you that I know what I heard, and I know what I saw, and I know that I'm sleeping upstairs in the office with Sherry tonight, right?
Well, okay. But the lights go out up there in exactly 2 minutes.
Let's lock it up tight. You guys check the windows.
Okay, I'm on my way.
Certainly stuck in here today. Well, that's okay. It'll give us a chance to write the opera.
Okay, let's do it. What do we do?
Well, to write an opera, the first thing that we need is a really good story with feeling, with emotion. A story about, say,
ghosts.
Yeah, smart-mouthed soapboxes.
Yeah, and headless snoopers.
Hey. I am not at all happy with the ghost panic that's going on around here.
Okay, look, guys.
What?
I promise you, kids, don't worry. Any ghost that messes with us is going to get his head knocked off.
Well, thanks, I guess.
What did you say?
Well, I just said that any ghost that messes with us should get his head handed to him.
Oh, that's it. That is the opera that we should write. Oh, what is the name of that story? The Headless Horseman.
Yeah, The Headless Horseman, The Legend of Sleepy Hollow.
The story has 3 characters. Ooh, and there's 3 of you. There's Ichabod Crane, the nerdy guy, yeah. And there's Brom Bones, the handsome dude.
And the beautiful Katrina.
Okay, guys, so here's what we can do.
Oh, kids, that graveyard that you drew is absolutely spooky.
Sorry,
but the front door was locked, so I came around the back.
Welcome, Joseph.
Guy.
Wow.
What? Oh,
is
yes.
This a birthday party or the set for Nightmare on Elm Street?
It's for our opera. Uh-huh. Oh, don't ask. Come on.
Oh, it's free. Oh.
Hey. 1, 2, 3. Surprise! Happy birthday, Cookie!
Oh, don't cry.
Can
you have a seat, big guy?
You remember
it.
Oh, you think we forget your birthday?
Well,
excuse me.
I don't know.
This is Joseph.
Joseph the pie man?
What are those?
Pies.
Pies. What are the rest of you going to have?
Gentlemen, in honor of our darling friend Cookie and his birthday, we have written a brand new spook opera, The Legend of Sleepy Hollow.
Yay!
Yay! In the town of Sleepy Hollow on this mighty cheer, there's a special dinner party, everyone is here. And if the party should get scary, we would say that's ordinary. That's because tonight is Halloween. It's Halloween.
Halloween.
It's Halloween.
Halloween.
Everyone invited will be beautifully dressed. At the banquet table, there's a place set for each guest.
But while the meal is barbecuing, there is also trouble brewing. Listen, and you'll find out what we mean. Just what we mean.
What we mean.
Just what we mean. What we mean. My name is Ichabod Crane, and I don't like to complain, but people sometimes treat me bad. They say that I'm an odd bird. They laugh and call me a nerd, but I don't let that make me sad. And I can tell you why I'm always happy as can be. It's 'cause I love Katrina, and she loves me.
One they call Katrina the loveliest by far. In the town of Sleepy Hollow, I'm treated like a star. But it isn't just a pretty face that sets me apart. Besides being beautiful, I'm also very smart. No, it wasn't just my looks, it was also my brain that won the heart of Ichabod Crane.
And although we seem a perfect pair to everyone who's seen us, that mean and nasty Mr. Brumbones wants to come between us. They call me Brumbones and people say I'm one cool dude. I've also heard them say I got a bad attitude. Katrina should have been mine, but she chose Ichabod. She picked him instead of me, and I think that's really odd. But I have a plan that I know won't fail. I'll scare Ichabod away with a spooky tale of the headless horseman.
Isn't this a lovely party?
Not as lovely as you are. What do you see in that goofy school teacher?
He's not goofy, he's sweet, and he's always here for me.
I wouldn't be so sure. Everybody gather round and listen if you dare. Once a horseman lost his head, he's buried over there. And here's a part that's really scary. If you're near that cemetery, he comes back each year on Halloween. On Halloween.
Halloween.
Halloween. It's late and I gotta run. The party's over and done. I'm tired and need to get some sleep. I know a shortcut today, but it could be a mistake since graveyards all give me the creeps. So now I'm on my way and soon I'll be home in my bed. Oh no, is that a horseman with a pumpkin for a head? I am the Headless Horseman, I'll bet that you have heard of me. Oh, I've come back from the grave and I'm unhappy as can be. Oh no! Each Halloween I'll appear until I find my head. Since I haven't found it yet, I'll scare you instead.
How dare you wake! You must be punished!
Oh, let me out of here!
What was that?
Well, I don't know, but I didn't like it.
Talk about losing your head!
Bravo! Magnificent! By the way, which of you played the horseman?
Maybe I can still catch him.
Oh, boy, oh, boy. I can honestly say, in all my life, I've never had a birthday like this one.
This is the weirdest thing I have ever seen.
You guys, there's nothing out there. There's no tire tracks, there's no footprints, nothing.
There has to be an explanation. I just don't know what it is.
Hang on to your hats, folks. We got videotape.
Wow.
This is my present to Cookie, so he can see what a good time he's having at his birthday party.
I didn't know there was a videotape.
Well, look at the time. I've got to go. Thank you very much for having me.
Do I chase him?
Well, I don't think you have to. Look.
This belong to anybody?
Okay, okay. No. This is where the weirdness starts. Check it out. Check it out. You see? Now that's where he got up and left.
Where did he go?
And why?
I bet you thought if you made enough noise, we would have noticed you were gone, right?
It almost works.
Yeah, but what about the talking cleaning supplies in the closet?
Puppets.
And the headless man?
Well, that's easy. Yeah.
Why would you go to so much trouble just to scare us?
You know, I thought I'd never miss this place. When I saw you doing so well, I thought I could scare you out. Buy the place back cheap.
Boy, you are a real loser.
Yeah, why don't you go find yourself some other dump to haunt?
Let's go.
And good riddance. Well, I guess it's time for me to go on home.
No.
No?
Oh, not so fast, Bucko. Happy birthday.
Whoa, that's beautiful. Wait a minute. I can't blow out all those candles.
No. You don't have to. You make a wish, and the Charles horse is going to blow out all the candles.
How come?
Well, he has learned breath control, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, one, two,
three. I forgot to make a wish.
Too late.